When you're going to be in Jannah, you will have your own GPS. You will know your place in Jannah. What street do you live? What part of Jannah? What gate? Where will you be? The Prophet ﷺ told us, everyone will know his place in Jannah more than he knows his own house in this dunya.
Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, Malik Yawm al-Din. Iyaka na'budu wa Iyaka nasta'in. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. قل يا عبادي الذين أسرفوا على أنفسهم لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله إن الله يغفر الذنوب جميعا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. وأنيبوا إلى ربكم وأسلموا له من قبل أن يأتيكم العذاب ثم لا تنصرون. واتبعوا أحسن ما أنزل إليكم من ربكم من قبل أن يأتيكم العذاب بغتة وأنتم لا تشعرون. أن تقول نفس يا حسرة على ما فرطت في جنب الله وإن كنت لمن الساخرين. أو تقول لو أن الله هداني لكنت من المتقين. أو تقول حين ترى العذاب لو أن لي كرة فأكون من المحسنين. بلى قد جاءتك آياتي فكذبت بها واستكبرت وكنت من الكافرين. ويوم القيامة ترى الذين كذبوا على الله وجوههم مسودة أليس في جهنم مثوى للمتكبرين. وينجي الله الذين اتقوا بمفازتهم لا يمسهم السوء ولا هم يحزنون. الله خالق كل شيء وهو على كل شيء وكيل. له مقاليد السماوات والأرض والذين كفروا بآيات الله أولئك هم الخاسرون. قل أفغير الله تأمروني أعبد أيها الجاهلون. ولقد أوحي إليك وإلى الذين من قبلك لئن أشركت ليحبطن عملك ولتكونن من الخاسرين. بل الله فاعبد وكن من الشاكرين. وما قدر الله حق قدره والأرض جميعا قبضته يوم القيامة والسماوات مطويات بيمينه سبحانه وتعالى عما يشركون. ونفخ في الصور فصعق من في السماوات ومن في الأرض إلا من شاء الله ثم نفخ فيه أخرى فإذا هم قيام ينظرون. وأشرقت الأرض بنور ربها ووضع الكتاب وجيء بالنبيين والشهداء وقضي بينهم بالحق وهم لا يظلمون. ووفيت كل نفس ما عملت وهو أعلم بما يفعلون. وسيق الذين كفروا إلى جهنم زمرا حتى إذا جاءوها فتحت أبوابها وقال لهم خزنتها ألم يأتكم رسل منكم يتلون عليكم آيات ربكم وينذرونكم لقاء يومكم هذا قالوا بلى ولكن حقت كلمة العذاب على الكافرين قيل ادخلوا أبواب جهنم خالدين فيها فبئس مثوى المتكبرين وسيق الذين اتقوا ربهم إلى الجنة زمرا حتى إذا جاءوها وفتحت أبوابها وقال لهم خزنتها سلام عليكم طبتم فادخلوها خالدين وقالوا الحمد لله الذي صدقنا وعده وأورثنا الأرض نتبوأ من الجنة حيث نشاء فنعم أجر العاملين وترى الملائكة حافين من حول العرش يسبحون بحمد ربهم وقضي بينهم بالحق وقيل الحمد لله رب العالمين
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته My dear brothers in Islam الحمد لله I would like to also congratulate you for Alhamdulillah coming to the masjid for Salatul Fajr and Alhamdulillah this morning we will be and inshallah ta'ala enjoying the final leg of our journey in Surah Zumar and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begins with an amazing ayah and this ayah is so famous some of the companions, some of the ulama of tafsir, they have said this ayah is arja ayah fil Quran, is the ayah that gives people the most hope. It gives you optimism, mashallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said in this ayah, قُلْ Say to them, Ya Muhammad, يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ And say to them, my servants who have harmed yourselves by your own excess. Do not despair of Allah's mercy. Allah forgives all sins. He's truly the most forgiving, the most merciful. Yes, regardless of what sin you have done in this life, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you that sin as long as you make tawbah from it. There is another ayah where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَنْ يُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala لَا يَغْفِرُ أَنْ يُشْرَكَ بِهِ Allah will never forgive someone who has committed the sin of shirk. وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ But Allah will forgive anything other than that. Anything less than shirk. What is the difference between this ayah and that ayah? Where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this ayah Allah has said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yaghfiru dhunuba jami'an. Allah forgives all kinds of sins. This means if the person makes tawbah from it. Before the person dies, if he or she makes tawbah from the sin, even if that sin was shirk, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive them. What about if the person dies without making tawbah from the sin of shirk? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the next life, Allah will never forgive that person. But if the person dies committing sins other than shirk, and then after that he passes away without making tawbah from them, that person is tahta mashi'atillah. Meaning in the next life, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala might forgive him all those sins. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, قل يا عبادي الذين أسرفوا على أنفسهم لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله إن الله يغفر الذنوب جميعا. As long as you make tawbah from these sins, Allah will forgive you. The ulama of tafsir, they mention under this ayah, the man who has killed the 99 people and then after that went to the monk and said to him, do I have an opportunity to make tawbah? And he said to him, no, he killed him to make it 100. And then after that, he went to a alim, a knowledgeable man. He said to him, can I make tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? I have just killed 100 people. He said, yes, subhanallah. And then after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted his tawbah. Also, there were people who came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and told them, ya Rasulullah, we have committed so many sins. Will we be forgiven if we were to become Muslims? And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, yes. If you make tawbah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive all your past sins. And any one of us right now, regardless of how many sins we have committed, regardless of the type of sin that we have committed, regardless of how many times we have committed that sin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can forgive us that, as long as you make tawbah. And then Allah said, وَأَنِيبُوا إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ وَأَسْلِمُوا لَهُ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَأْتِيَكُمُ الْعَذَابُ ثُمَّ لَا تُنْصَرُونَ. Turn to your Lord, submit to Him before the punishment overtakes you and you can no longer be helped. وَاتَّبِعُوا أَحْسَنَ مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكُمْ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ وَاتَّبِعُوا أَحْسَنَ مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكُمْ. Follow the best teaching sent down to you from your Lord before the punishment suddenly takes you unaware. And then Allah said, "Antaqula nafsun ya hasrata." Amazing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how He warns us right now. "Antaqula nafsun ya hasrata." And your soul says, woe is me for having neglected what is due to Allah and having been one of those who scoffed. So the people who are disbelievers today, they are being told right now, before this day comes, when you will be saying, "Antaqula nafsun ya hasrata ala ma farrat." So before you regret and say, I wish I've done better than this, it's better that you make tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala today. أو تقول لو أن الله هداني. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, or it says, if Allah had guided me, I would have joined the righteous. Before you get to that day, before you get to that stage. أو تقول حين ترى العذاب. Or faced by punishment, by the time you see the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it says, if I could have another chance, I would join those who do good. So all of these things will not actually be any good to them. Allah said, Bala qad ja'atka ayati. Bala qad ja'atka ayati. No, indeed, my messages came to you and you rejected them. You were arrogant and rejected the truth. So this person who's a kafir, who's going to say in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the next life, I wish, he will be told, no indeed, bala, qad ja'atka ayati, my verses, my signs came to you, my messages came to you, and you rejected them. You were arrogant and rejected the truth. Wa yawm al-qiyamati, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, on the day of resurrection, you, O Prophet Muhammad, will see those who told lies against Allah, their faces darkened. Is there not ample punishment for the arrogant in hell? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said. وَيُنَجِّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا بِمَفَازَتِهِمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, but Allah will deliver those who took heed of Him to their place of safety. No harm will touch them, nor will they grieve. اللَّهُ خَالِقُ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, Allah, He is the one who created everything. Allah is the creator of all things. Allahu khaliqu kulli shay'in makhluq. This is very important. Allahu khaliqu kulli shay'in makhluq. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's the one who has created everything that is a creation. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's not a created being. So He did not create Himself. His names and attributes are also not created. Okay? So these belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created everything which is supposed to be created. So the speech of Allah is not created because it's part of Him. Allahu khaliqu kulli shay'in makhluq. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created everything that needs to be created. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, wa huwa ala kulli shay'in wakil. He has charge of everything. Lahu maqalidu as-samawati wal ard. The keys of the heavens and earth are His. The keys to the heaven and also to the earth, they belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ. Those who have rejected the revelation of Allah will be the losers. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to the Prophet, say to these people, قُلْ أَفَغَيْرَ اللَّهِ تَأْمُرُونِي أَعْبُدُ أَيُّهَا الْجَاهِلُونَ. They used to say to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, come and worship our gods, and we will worship your God. So you worship our gods 1 year, and we will worship Allah 1 year. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to the Prophet ﷺ, say to these people, أَفَغَيْرَ اللَّهِ تَأْمُرُونِي أَعْبُدُ أَيُّهَا الْجَاهِلُونَ. Do you order me to worship someone other than Allah, you foolish people? تَأْمُرُونِي أَعْبُدُ أَيُّهَا الْجَاهِلُونَ. And then, وَلَقَدْ أُوحِيَ إِلَيْكَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, it has already been revealed to you, Ya Muhammad, and to those before you, meaning the messengers who came before you and the people. If you ascribe any partner to Allah, all your work will come to nothing. SubhanAllah. The Prophet ﷺ is also being warned. He's being told, if you commit shirk, you will lose everything. All the khair you've done, it will just disappear. So this shows us how dangerous the act of shirk is. وَلَقَدْ أُوحِيَ إِلَيْكَ وَإِلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ لَإِنْ أَشْرَكْتَ لَيَحْبَطَنَّ عَمَلُكَ. The Prophet ﷺ is being told, if you commit shirk, خلاص, forget about your good deeds. They will go out of the window. لَإِنْ أَشْرَكْتَ لَيَحْبَطَنَّ عَمَلُكَ وَلَتَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. And the Prophet ﷺ was told, and you will be one of the losers as well. بَلِ اللَّهَ فَعْبُدْ وَكُمْ مِنَ الشَّاكِرِينَ. No, worship Allah alone and be one of those who are grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The next ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about what he will do in the next life. وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ وَالْأَرْضُ جَمِيعًا قَبْضَتُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ وَالسَّمَاوَاتُ مَطْوِيَّاتٌ بِيَمِينِهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى عَمَّا يُشْرِكُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, they made not a just estimate of Allah. وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ. They did not place Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his position. وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ. They made not a just estimate of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They have underestimated Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Such as is due to him. And on the day of resurrection, Allah said, the whole of the earth will be grasped by his hand. The whole earth will be grasped by his hand. And the heavens will be rolled up in his right hand. Glorified is he, and high is he above all that they associate as partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is what's going to happen in the next life. The day of judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what will he do? The whole earth will be grasped by his hand, and the heavens will be rolled up in his right hand. The seven heavens that are so huge will be rolled up in his right hand. How does the hand of Allah look like? We don't know. Has Allah got hands? Yes. How do we know that? He told us. His hands, do they look like our hands? No. Do they look like the hands of another creation? No. Because Allah said, لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ. So whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has attributed himself to, we affirm it. And we say that we have affirmed that. Whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said that has negated it, we also negate it from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ. There's no one who's like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ. At the same time, he's the one who hears and also sees. And then look at the next ayah. Allah has taken us to another stage. وَنُفِخَ فِي الصُّورِ فَصَعِقَ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا مَنْ شَاءَ اللَّهِ. And the trumpet will be sounded, and everyone in the heavens and earth will fall down, senseless, except those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spares. It will be sounded once again, and they will be on their feet looking on. SubhanAllah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say, while he was still alive, كَيْفَ أَنْعَمْ وَصَاحِبُ الْقَرْنِ قَدْ الْتَقَمَ الْقَرْنِ. وَحَنَّ جَبْحَتَهُ. SubhanAllah. The Prophet ﷺ used to say, how can I feel comfortable in this life? When the sahibul qarn iltaqam al-qarn. When the angel who is supposed to be blowing the trumpet has placed the trumpet between his lips. And now he's looking and listening and just waiting for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give him the order to blow it. He said, how can I feel comfortable? That angel has already placed the trumpet between his lips. All he's waiting for right now is to be told to blow it. So the Prophet used to say, kayfa an'am. How am I going to feel comfortable when I know the angel that's supposed to be blowing the trumpet has placed the trumpet in its mouth? SubhanAllah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us the trumpet will be blown twice. The first time everyone is going to die. The second time everyone will be resurrected. وَأَشْرَقَتِ الْأَرْضُ بِنُورِ رَبِّهَا وَوُضِعَ الْكِتَابِ. The earth will shine with the light of its Lord. What will happen in the next life, the beginning of the next life? The day of judgment, the heaven will be khalas. The sun will disappear, the sun itself. What will, how will the earth get light? It will get light from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yeah. وَأَشْرَقَتِ الْأَرْضُ بِنُورِ رَبِّهَا. There's no sun, there's no moon, there's nothing, there's no stars. All of those things are taken out. خلاص. So how will, everyone is going to just get up in darkness. يَوْمَ تُبَدَّلُ الْأَرْضُ غَيْرَ الْأَرْضِ وَالسَّمَوَاتُ مَطْوِيَاتِ بِيَمِينِ. Subhanallah. So the earth that we live in will be changed. A different earth is going to be brought about. And when people get up, there's going to be darkness. How will we get light? وَأَشْرَقَتِ الْأَرْضُ بِنُورِ رَبِّهَا. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala arrives to judge between the people, the light of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's what will give the earth a light. Allahu Akbar. وَأَشْرَقَتِ الْأَرْضُ بِنُورِ رَبِّهَا. وَوُضِعَ الْكِتَابُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, after that, the record of deeds will be laid down, will be laid open. The prophets will be brought and witnesses as well. The Prophet ﷺ, when they brought back in that day, they will witness against their people. They will say, Ya Allah, we have delivered the message to them. Imagine Prophet Nuh coming and saying to Allah, Ya Allah, I have delivered the message you have given to me, to my people. He's going to be a witness against his own people. Prophet Ibrahim will be a witness against his own people. Prophet Musa will be a witness against his own people. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he will be a witness against his own people. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in his Hajj, the final sermon that he was giving in Hajj, ala hal ballaght. He used to say, have I delivered the message? And the companions were saying yes, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was saying, Allahumma ashhad, Ya Allah, be a witness. Subhanallah. So the Prophet ﷺ, he's going to witness against his own people. Also, the angels will be brought. وَأَشْرَقَتِ الْأَرْضُ بِنُورِ رَبِّهَا وَوُضِعَ الْكِتَابُ وَجِئَ بِالنَّبِيِّينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ. وَالشُّهَدَاءِ, they're the angels. Angels will be coming as well. They will be brought in. Fair judgment will be given between them. Allah said, they will not be wronged. وَوُفِّيَتْ كُلُّ نَفْسٍ مَا عَمِلَتْ وَهُوَ أَعْلَمُ. And every soul will be repaid in full for what it has done. He knows best what they do. وَهُوَ أَعْلَمُ بِمَا يَفْعَلُونَ. And the final passage of the surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us how the people of hellfire, how they will be brought to the hellfire. The people of Jannah, how they will be brought to Jannah. Those who, Allah said, those who rejected the truth will be led to hell in their throngs, like in groups. When they arrive, its gates will open and its keepers will say to them, do you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءُوهَا فُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُهَا. As soon as they get to the doors of hellfire, the doors will be opened straight away. There's no time for them to wait outside. As soon as they get there, the doors will be opened. In the next ayah, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the people of Jannah, when they get to the doors of Jannah, the doors of Jannah will not be opened straight away. Because Jannah is expensive. I can't just go in. You have and Jannah needs intercession, shafa'ah, for the doors to be opened. Subhanallah, you can't just go in. So everybody will be standing in front of Jannah. That's why Allah said, وَفُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُهَا. But when the people of hellfire, when they're brought to the hellfire, the doors of hellfire will be opened quickly. So they are thrown into it. So حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءُوهَا فُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُهَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said. And then وَقَالَ لَهُمْ خَزَنَتُهَا. The angels that are taking care of the hellfire, they will say to these people who deserve to be thrown into the hellfire, أَلَمْ يَأْتِكُمْ رُسُلٌ مِّنْكُمْ. Did you guys not get messengers who are from you, from your own people? Were you not sent messengers who came from your own people? أَلَمْ يَأْتِكُمْ رُسُلٌ مِّنْكُمْ يَتْلُونَ عَلَيْكُمْ آيَاتِ رَبِّكُمْ وَيُنذِرُونَكُمْ لِقَاءَ يَوْمِكُمْ. They will say to them, were you not sent your own messengers to recite the revelation of your Lord to you and warn you that you would meet this day? لِقَاءَ يَوْمِكُمْ هَذَا وَيُنذِرُونَكُمْ لِقَاءَ يَوْمِكُمْ هَذَا. Those people, what will they say? قَالُوا بَلَى. Indeed, they came to us. They will admit it. They will say, imagine Abu Jahl, Al-Walid ibn al-Mughira, Fir'aun, people like them, Haman, Qarun, dragged to the hellfire. And they will be asked, did you not get a message? Messengers from you guys, were they not sent to you? They will be saying yes. Imagine, how will they be feeling that moment? They will be admitting it. They will say, yeah, we had messengers coming to us, but we didn't listen to them. قَالُوا بَلَى وَلَكِنْ حَقَّتْ كَلِمَةُ الْعَذَابِ عَلَى الْكَافِرِينَ. What will they say? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us. And they will say, yes, indeed we were. But the sentence of punishment will have been passed against those who rejected the truth. قِيلَ ادْخُلُوا أَبْوَابَ جَهَنَّمُ. What will be said to them? It will be said to them, enter the gates of hell. There you will remain. How evil is the abode of the arrogant people. Subhanallah. May Allah not make us from those people. Look at the next ayah. وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا رَبَّهُمْ إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ زُمَرًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, those who were mindful of their Lord. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those ones. You are mindful of your Lord right now. That's why you woke up. If you weren't mindful of your Lord, you would not have woken up. You would have been asleep. You wouldn't care. You would have been enjoying your sleep right now. But because of the taqwa of Allah, you woke up. You woke up. You said, I want to go to the masjid. I want to stand before my Lord who gave me whatever I have. I want to stand up before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to thank Him for all the things He gave me, for all the great stuff He gave me. That's why you woke up. So, وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا رَبَّهُمْ. Those who are fearful of Allah. Those who are very mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those, they will be taken to where? وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا رَبَّهُمْ إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ زُمَرًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those who were mindful of their Lord will be led in throngs to the garden. When they arrive, they will find it is gates. وَفُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُهَا. Wide open. Subhanallah. The gates of Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us, hellfire has got لَهَا سَبْعَةُ أَبْوَاب. Hellfire has got 7 gates. But as for Jannah, Jannah has got 8 gates. 8 gates. And these gates are very wide. Just imagine the doors, the gates will be opened. And when the gates are opened, these gates are not like small gates. They are so wide. The distance between Mecca, the distance between Medina and Sana'a. That's how wide the gate is. It's like one of the gates. Or some of the hadith mentioned, the width of the gate is like 40 years, the distance of 40 years. But when people are going to enter paradise, you can almost feel, subhanAllah, the tension. And the edges of the door, you can hear the squeaking because people will be rushing into it. SubhanAllah, amazing. Allahu Akbar. وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا رَبَّهُمْ إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ زُمَرًا حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءُوهَا وَفُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُهَا وَقَالَ لَهُمْ خَزَنَتُهَا. Look at the difference. Those who were being thrown into the hellfire. What was the first thing that the angels have said to them, those who were in charge of the hellfire? أَلَمْ يَأْتِكُمْ رُسُلٌ مِّنْكُمْ. Guys, didn't you get messengers from your own people? But look at the angels of Jannah. What will they say to the people of Jannah? سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ. Allahu Akbar. Just imagine that moment. I want you to travel. And just imagine that moment. SubhanAllah. Do you know when people win something and they're given, or how happy people become? Imagine the day that you win the ticket to enter paradise. And you're at the door and you look around and you see messengers, you see righteous people. SubhanAllah. And all the people that you can see, their faces are so full of light and happiness. Just imagine those moments. I want you to replay in your head right now. You cannot even do it. You cannot imagine it. It's so hard to imagine it. SubhanAllah. Because we will not look like this. We'll be very different. And the amazing thing is, when you're going to be in Jannah, you will have your own GPS. Okay? Because how would you know your address? Everything will be programmed in you, SubhanAllah. You will know your place in Jannah. What street do you live? What part of Jannah? What gate? Where will you be? SubhanAllah. Look at everything has been sorted out. Just imagine the administrational work that will go into it. SubhanAllah. Another level. I want you to think a bit further, you know. So just imagine Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He gives everybody, subhanAllah, your own address, your email address, everything, and you know where you're going. Okay, where are you going to live? I've got my own GPS. I know where I'm. The Prophet ﷺ told us, everyone will know his place in Jannah more than he knows his own house in this dunya. Allah. It's unbelievable stuff. وَسِيقَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا رَبَّهُمْ إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ زُمَرًا حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءُوهَا وَفُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُهَا وَقَالَ لَهُمْ خَزَنَتُهَا سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ طِبْتُمْ. طِبْتُمْ. That's what the angels of Jannah will say to them. Peace be upon you. You have been good. Imagine when the angels admit and say to you guys, you've been good. SubhanAllah. When the angels testify that you have been really good, guys. طِبْتُمْ. And then they will say to you, فَدْخُلُوهَا خَالِدِينَ. SubhanAllah. Come in, you are here to stay. SubhanAllah. Just imagine who's hosting you there, the angels. And then more importantly, you are the guest of Allah after that as well. Allahu Akbar. Just imagine. Always have that image in your head. SubhanAllah. Try to remember that. Imagine it. Wallahi, we will never be able to imagine it. SubhanAllah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what He has prepared for us, like the Prophet said, مَا لَا عَيْنٌ رَأَتْ وَلَا أُذُنٌ سَمِعَتْ وَلَا خَطَرَ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِ بَشَرٍ. SubhanAllah. SubhanAllah. مَا لَا عَيْنٌ رَأَتْ. What eyes have never seen. SubhanAllah. Whatever we imagine right now, Jannah will always be different. Very different. SubhanAllah. How are we going to look like? How are we going to be? How are we going to interact with each other? SubhanAllah. And how are we going to enjoy every moment of Jannah? Salamun alaykum tibtum fadkhuluha khalideen. You will be there forever. We will never be told in Jannah one day, guys, you have been here long enough. I have given you more than you deserve. Can you check out? No way. Allah is more generous than that. Allah will never say, oh guys, I've been too generous with you guys. Okay, you have only worshipped me for 20 years. And now I allowed you to stay in my Jannah for billions of years. So now it's the time for you to disappear. No. Allah will say to you, no, stay in Jannah. Forever. Forever and ever. Just imagine, you know, this life is so short, but we are full of it. We want to live here forever. Wallahi, akhi, ikhwani, you should not desire to live here for too long, SubhanAllah, because our permanent home, whenever we lose someone, we become sad. Why are you being sad, SubhanAllah? That person is going to go to the next life, which is the permanent life, SubhanAllah. Abu Darda used to say, death is good for the believer and it's also good for the disbeliever. And Abu Darda was asked, why did you say death is even good for the disbeliever? He said, when the disbeliever dies, his sins will stop. If he lives, the longer he lives, the more sins he will accumulate and the further punishment he will deserve. And he said, the believer is good for him to die. Why? Because وَمَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ خَيْرٌ لِلْأَبْرَارِ. What is waiting for the good people is far better than what they have in this life. SubhanAllah. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, وَقَالُوا الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ. When the people of Jannah enter paradise, what will they say? Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah is so important, that word. Alhamdulillah. الَّذِي صَدَقَنَا وَعْدَهُ. They will say, look, and they will say, praise be to Allah who has kept His promise to us and given us this land as our own. SubhanAllah. Do you know, we will remember the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we will say, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has kept His promise. He didn't break. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُخْلِفُ الْمِعَادِ. Wallahi, ikhwani, do you know, your salah, your effort, your ajr, it's not going to go to waste. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never lose it. SubhanAllah. And Allah will always multiply it for us. SubhanAllah. So Allah has said, وَقَالُوا الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي صَدَقَنَا وَعْدَهُ وَأَوْرَثَنَا الْأَرْضِ. He has made us inherit this land. Now we may live wherever we please in Jannah. وَأَوْرَثَنَا الْأَرْضِ نَتَبَوَّأُ مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ حَيْثُ نَشَاءُ. They will be allowed to live wherever they want. SubhanAllah. نَتَبَوَّأُ حَيْثُ نَشَاءُ. مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ حَيْثُ نَشَاءُ فَنِعْمَ أَجْرُ الْعَامِلِينَ. They will say, how excellent is the reward of those who labor. Those who work hard, how excellent their ajr is, SubhanAllah. And the last ayah, وَتَرَى الْمَلَائِكَةَ. That day, what else will you see? وَتَرَى الْمَلَائِكَةَ حَافِينَ مِنْ حَوْلِ الْعَرْشِ يُسَبِّحُونَ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّهِمْ. SubhanAllah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, you, Ya Muhammad, Prophet Muhammad, will see the angels surrounding the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in that day, glorifying their Lord. In the day of judgment, the angels will be surrounding the arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what are they doing? Glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with praise. True judgment will have been passed between them, and it will be said, praise be to Allah, the Lord of the worlds. وَقِيلَ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. So the surah has ended with Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Amazing, amazing. Isn't it amazing, brothers?
Yeah.
MashaAllah. This is the beauty of the Quran. It takes you from one scene to the next. Makes you enjoy different parts of this mashallah creation. And inshaAllah ta'ala, how the passage is all the way to Allah subhanahu wa tells you from the beginning to the end. Everything. SubhanAllah, is amazing, the Quran. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us those who take heed from it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us those who will meet with one another in Jannah and remind each other about these amazing moments that we have together in this life. SubhanAllah. And that will happen, inshaAllah ta'ala. That will happen. It's not too long. Don't think it's like too far away. It's very soon. Because this life is very short. Yeah, this life is very, very short. The next one is forever. Okay, next one is forever. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reunite us together in that next life. And may Allah make us those who love one another for the sake of Allah in this dunya, and those who will enjoy paradise together. And mashallah, Allahu Akbar. Give each other a nice hug before you go. Congratulate each other and say, I will see you in Jannah, inshallah. Barakallahu fiikum. Assalamu alaikum. Everyone, give your brother a nice